Get back
what
to
do you
work
want?
Already. Don't make me tell you again.
Looks like someone isn't
hey,
doing
I'm
their
look
job.
Around.
Please, no. No! No more!
Hey, I'll be over there. Just
work hard, they'll leave you be.
Yeah?
Hey, man.
How you doing?
What's going on, huh?
Sure.
Stop by soon.
Yeah, okay. See you.
Supplies, weapons. Thanks. Good choice. Can I get anything else for you? Yeah, all right. I'll be here. Later.
Metolius Springs. Yeah, I know where that is. Big loser. I just caught a break. That Nero radio might actually be useful. I know where they're going tomorrow.
Wait, I thought you said you couldn't take them on.
No, I can't. But with a little luck, I can get to their chopper without being seen. And
give them hell, brother. Remember what Jack used to say? Don't ride faster than your guardian angel can fly.
Like I said, Jack used to say a lot of stupid shit. Deacon out. All right, let's go see what the hell Nero is up to. Jesus, something went down. Wonder if the poor bastards had anything worth looking for. Nero Beacon. Okay, where is it? Yes, Nero Injector. Was feeling a little under the weather. A micro recorder. Let's see.
Come on, pull back. Pull back.
Pull back.
Pull back. What the hell is that thing? I don't know. Goddamn scientists. What do we do? What do we do?
Shit, you're trapped. You're back.
We're trapped.
Shit.
There's no way out.
Jesus, what the hell was that? Let's just hope we don't have to find out.
St. John, you out there? I got a job for you here at the Hot Springs.
Docker, okay, I'll head your way. St. John out.
Some marauders, yeah, yeah. Go kill each other.
I got a use for you. Killing freaks. Doing something right for a change.
that?
Hey, me again. Boozer says that I shouldn't come up here anymore. He keeps asking me what good's it do, and maybe he's right, I don't know. He got hurt pretty bad the other day. We ran into some rippers who burned the hell out of his arm, and it looks pretty bad. I broke into one of those, what the hell do you call them? The mobile medical units? I mean, I got him sterile bandages. And I hope it's enough. You know, but Boozer, you know, he says he's fine, but I don't think so. Shit looks pretty bad to me. See, the thing is, it was on me. I risked his life for a bike part. Goddamn bike part. Not that it mattered. Son of a bitch Copeland parted it out anyway. Took me a year to put that bike together. You would have liked it. It's not as nice as the one that I taught you to ride on, but it got me around. Do you remember that tank that you had painted for me? Oh, that was the only thing left of that old hog, and now it's gone too. As soon as we get it back together, my bike, I mean, and get Boozer patched up, we're gonna ride north. Fresh start. Yeah, a lot of memories around here. Too many. Anyway. I guess I'm just saying that, I might not see you again, you know? Use this. Oh, here we go. That should be it.
Come on.
Murderers and thieves, the lot of you. How many people you killed today, huh?
Help! 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 Over here! I'm here! Help me! Help! Please!
Hey, hey, hey. It's okay. You want to die out here? Look, there's a camp...
Where? Where? I'll go! I'll go!
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Thank you so much. I thought I was gonna die in there.
Tell him it was Deacon. Deacon St. John. Now just keep running. Stay off the road.
So, you want to learn how to hunt? Is that what I'm hearing?
I know how to shoot a gun.
It's a rifle, not a gun.
I was in the 10th Mountain Cope. Don't give me any of your Marine Corps bullshit.
Killing a buck's a little different than killing a man. Or a freak. The best way to hunt an animal is to track it. You gotta focus. And see what nature's trying to tell you. If you look hard enough, you'll see the signs. Okay, then. Look hard. See this pile of deer scat? It's fresh.
Yeah, I see it.
They lead this way.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, come on, then.
Quick, there's your buck.
I see him. Now here, use my rifle. If you were in the 10th Mountain, you know how to use a scope.
Yeah, Cope, I know how to use a scope.
Easy, easy.
I got this.
Got him. Nice shot.
Oh, goddammit, it wasn't a kill shot. He got away.
No, no, that's okay. You wounded him. He'll bleed out soon enough. You just gotta track him.
Okay.
See the blood spots? Look close.
Yeah, I see him.
Then follow him.
On it.
He'll be slowing down about now. Losing too much blood. We should be coming across his carcass anytime now. Okay, you know how to gut an animal?
Yeah, look. Cope, Boozer, and I have been hunting before. He used to go elk hunting with his old man, and yeah, he showed me how to gut a deer.
Well, let's just say, no disrespect to Boozer, but you got a lot to learn. You're wasting a lot of meat there. Overall, not bad for a beginner.
Yeah, thanks.
Now, I'll take back that rifle.
Here, thanks.
Like I said, Deke, we can always use more venison at the camp. Still got some folks trying to heal up from that Ripper attack.
Okay, Cope. Yeah, I'll see if I can remember that.
Keeping an eye on that gas truck. One with the custom paint job you've been asking about
before. Manny, I'm still not happy with you.
Like a bunch of Alzheimer's patients. Only pissed off. Strong. You want to tear your guts out.
That's all I got.
Hey, how's it going?
Jazzy.
Hey! Nice.
That's all I got for now.
Hey, see ya.
See you later.
What do you need?
Just looking.
Can I help you? Nice.
Nope.
Okay. I'll be here if you need anything.
Cope says you've been helping out around the camp. He won't say it, but he appreciates it.
Hey, Manny.
I'll wrap that up for you.
Cool. Need anything else? Good choice, man. Good choice. Oh, yeah, that's a good piece. This should last you for a while. I'll wrap that up for you. Should have more stuff later.
No, I'll keep an eye out for more shit. See you around, man.
You, need something, man?
Manny, what's going on?
All right, check back later, man. See you,
Deacon.
Just looking. What's up?
Let me get the gate for you.
How's it going, Booze Man?
Fine, goddammit. Hey, Deke, we're getting low on supplies. We need some more meat if you get a chance.
Oh, shit. Okay. I guess it's been a while since we did any hunting. I'll see if I can scare up some meat while I'm out.
Do you remember what you're doing?
Yeah, I had Cope give me a few pointers, believe it or not.
Cope? Shit, I don't believe it. Thanks, Deke.
See you, Booze Man. Alright, now I just gotta find some deer, bear, wolf, fuck, don't matter to me.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. I grew up in these here woods. My grandfather taught me all about hunting.
Wolf.
Funny how it still works in a world he never would have dreamed of. I built my first treehouse to use as a deer blind. Hidden height on the target helps your aim and keeps you safe. Back then, I took out my first doe from up top. Today, my camp's up in the trees. You want to survive and can contribute, you come to me. We got you covered. Grandfather also taught me to catch a doe. Sometimes you gotta lay an ambush.
God damn, Angela.
Hide where they need to go. Like a water pump. Today, you're as likely to be prey as hunter. So you can have your eyes peeled and you're hitting a a snare by a tree. Then you can have dinner next time you come around.
Gotcha.
Be careful. A headless snake can still bite. Especially when it ain't really dead. My grandfather would have outlived us all. Let me tell you. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Great! Hope so. You and your granddaddy set traps for him. And you and your old man used to lay down salt licks. That's real sporting.
Guess none of that shit matters now.
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
I'm not a doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sorry, Lieutenant O'Brien. How long are we going to be here?
Thanks, Doc. I thought I saw something on our approach. I'm going to check it out.
Yeah?
Where's Carrie?
Okay, Doc. Lieutenant, don't become carrion yourself.
Only animals can become carrion, Corporal, not humans. You guys checked the perimeter, right?
Yeah, it's clear.
Lieutenant O'Brien? 006. On approach to the landing site, I observed a large swarm of insects, probably Demonocitratus or Diptera, in a clearing well away from our designated target. From that distance, I could not discern what was attracting the insects, but from the size of the swarm, the recent carrion is indicated. Should be just over here. Damn it, where is it? Ah, here it is. Speculation as to Demonocitratus is confirmed. Lots of horseflies here. Glad to have the suit on. Carrion is still mostly intact and appears to be what a Corvius Minus or.
Anyone else see something?
I guess if anybody could check that. Striation of the larger muscle masses indicate infection of Hooligan strain HB. We'll take sample to confirm.
Stop right there!
I don't want any trouble.
Speculation as to Demonocitratus is confirmed. Carrion is still mostly intact and appears to infection of Hurlogan strain HB. We'll take sample to confirm.
This way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself, and I would have added something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero, Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, that if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes, I am.
How? How are you alive,
O'Brien? What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night,
Nero Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb for goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell else you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little space suit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead, so I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but... I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't. Please, you don't... Hey, you don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife... I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't gonna make it, but I got her to the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
Ryan,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Is alive. If he is, Nero.
Rose, man. A few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole old line.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Get some shut-eye, Booze, man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah, Deke. Okay.
O'Brien. Are you out there? O'Brien! You son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? You know you're on this channel? God damn it. Okay, you better get back to me or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, God damn it. Oh, come on! O'Brien! Get back to me.
Deke, you there? Did you track down the chopper? Was it the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night?
Yeah, it was him.
And did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
You don't think she's still alive?
What? No. I mean, no, look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Where she died.
Some peace.
I don't need to find any peace, Jesus. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oracle. The truth shall set you free. Broke another goddamn razor this morning. And I'm supposed to... Instead of getting the best products from around the world, we got the shittiest products cheap foreign labor could churn out. Everything in the last 50 years was built to break, so that you could buy once, buy again, buy. You always had to get the new car, the new phone, the new this and that, all to feed the beast of crass commercialism. You want something built to last? You couldn't go overseas, nope. You need real, hard-working Americans at the helm. When we build something, it'll stand the test of time. And the same hands that built this country, they'll withstand anything this new world throws at us. Our roads bend, friends, but they do not break. And neither will we. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
They look pretty broken to me, Cope, but hey, whatever you say. Nothing wrong with a little crass commercialism. Hell, I could use a new bike right about now.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, booze man, I brought in some meat. Should keep us stocked up for a while.
Hey, Deke, thanks, man. I'm not real hungry right now. I'll salt it up in a bit.